Hello students, in this video we will talk about the wireless technologies. So let us start. What has been written in your text? For wireless communication, electromagnetic waves are used. The frequency of these waves are measured in hertz, Hz. The property of these waves changes with the frequency of electromagnetic waves. First of all, we should know that for setup of a computer network, we use several types of the media in which wireless and wired network are established. In wired network, the computers are connected by wires or cable, but in wireless network, the network is established without using networking cable, using wireless technologies. These may be Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, infrared, and WiMAX. These type of the systems are used for connecting the computer, and via these methods information are transferred, right? So here let us discuss about wireless technology. In this for connecting computer, electromagnetic waves are used, and the frequency of these waves are measured in hertz. Hertz is the unit of frequency, and the property of these waves changes with the frequency of electromagnetic waves. It means the property of the wave depends on the frequency. Now let us study what are the different types of the wireless technology. First of all, here it is very general. You know this symbol. This is the symbol of Bluetooth. You have seen it in your mobile. And now let us discuss what is Bluetooth. It is one of the most popular technologies used in handheld mobiles and tablets devices for transmission of data. Its frequency ranges from 2.402 gigahertz to 2.480 gigahertz and is therefore used for short range communication, approximately 10 meter. Its data transfer rate is too slow in comparison to other waves. This Bluetooth technology is used for connecting the computers or nodes within the range of 10 meter, and the data transfer rate is also very slow, and the frequency of Bluetooth is 2.402 gigahertz to 2.480 gigahertz. But this can be used for a very local area network, very small area, about ranging about 10 meters. So you all have used this Bluetooth technologies for sharing the files, sharing the photos, sharing the small files from one computer or one mobile to the another mobile. So this is common to all. Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is the acronym of wireless fidelity, which gives you a chance to unite with the web without an intermediate line from your PC to ISP. PC means personal computer, and ISP means internet service provider. And for Wi-Fi to work, you require a broadband net connectivity, wireless router transfer your web association from ISP to PC, a smartphone, laptop, desktop with remote web card, or outer wireless connector. Transmitting machine information without wires makes information particularly defenseless to the programmer. Machines client who can catch your association and take your information. In the event that you choose to utilize Wi-Fi at home, make sure that the system you set up is secure. Wi-Fi, which is wireless fidelity, this is the full form of Wi-Fi is wireless fidelity, is generally used nowadays to establish network, but it is insecure. It is insecure. It should Now it is being protected somewhat by using some passwords, but how can you establish this network? For establish this network, we use a broadband connectivity, a wireless router transfer, a wireless router, and a smartphone, laptop, desktop, what do you want to connect with the network. Now here, this is used for transferring the data, and it has more speed than that of the Bluetooth. Now next is Wi-Fi hotspot. Wi-Fi hotspots are a special area in which wireless or Wi-Fi can be accessed, right? So what has been written here, a hotspot is a venue means place that offers Wi-Fi access. People in general can utilize portable computer, Wi-Fi telephones or other suitable compact gadgets to get the web through Wi-Fi hotspot. Hotspots are areas, for example, libraries, inns, air terminals, and nearby bookshops, restaurants, and so on, with nominal fee-based remote web access. There are Wi-Fi hotspot in a huge number of areas around the globe. What has been written? Bangalore is the first Indian city to be free Wi-Fi hotspot. It means basically hotspots are the area where Wi-Fi can be offered freely, generally, or in very less cost. And using here, these are the areas where access network access can be done very easily. So, and here the Bangalore is the first Indian city to offer free Wi-Fi hotspot. It means Bangalore was the first city to offer free Wi-Fi hotspot. It means in there you can use Wi-Fi free. Now next one is WiMAX. WiMAX is the acronyms of Worldwide Interoperability for Microwave Access. Its speed is more, and it covers large area up to 30 miles to 50 miles. So let us discuss what has been written in your text. WiMAX is wireless digital communication system that provides broadband wireless access, BWA means broadband wireless access, up to 30 miles to 50 miles. Its area is very much greater than that of Wi-Fi for fixed station. If the station are stationary, they are not moving. But when these are set up in moving condition, for example, someone is present in any automobile or any train. So in this condition, it covers about 10 miles or 5 to 15 kilometers for mobile stations, if the stations are moving. Now next one, in contrast, the Wi-Fi wireless local area network standard is limited to 100 meter in most cases. It means the Wi-Fi area has very less range. Generally it is used for 30 to 100 meter, but the range of WiMAX is very much, as you have seen here, it is about 30 miles, about 50 kilometer for a stationary station, but it is 3 to 10 miles, it means 5 to 15 kilometers for mobile workstation. Now next thing we have to study that what are the other properties of characteristics of WiMAX. So let us discuss. WiMAX requires a tower. Here you can see this is the tower. called WiMAX base station. The name of this tower is WiMAX base station, similar to cell phone tower, which is connected to the internet using a standard wired high speed connection. These towers are just similar to the mobile stations or Now next thing is, here we have seen that WiMAX require a tower called WiMAX base station, similar to a cell phone tower, which is connected to the internet using a standard wired high speed connection. It means a phone tower uses the wires, but here in this WiMAX no wire are used and they are connected using a standard and the phones are used phone towers are used to the internet using a standard wired high speed connection, but as opposed to a traditional internet service provider, which divides the bandwidth among the customers via wire. In the wire network, broadband is divided using different types of the cables, but here wires are not used, and this is in the WiMAX, microwave links are used, established for the connection. In the other word, WiMAX does not depend on cables to connect each end point. The internet connectivity to an end user is provided through microwave link between the tower and user end point, known as WiMAX subscriber unit. It means what? Here in WiMAX, the connection between the tower and the unit where is to be connected is connection is made by the using microwave links, right? And these points are known as WiMAX subscriber unit. It means this tower is providing service to that unit or linked with that unit, which is known as WiMAX subscriber unit. It is most advanced and its speed and area is very much. That is why it is one of the most advanced technology. Now here another thing is dongle. In general saying, you know it as net setter. Here you are looking, this is the net setter or dongle. Here Wi-Fi modem, its name is Wi-Fi modem, and you might have used the network dongles of Photon, which was very friendly or the familiar, the dongles of Micromax and the dongles of HP are very simpler, in which some kind of SIMs are used, and by using this network connection can be utilized. A dongle additionally called an internet dongle, it is little USB gadget. It means this is connected to the USB port gadget that permits you to connect to web. A dongle may be either a 3G generation, third generation or fourth generation dongle, right? It means it may be of 3G technology or 4G technology. Sometimes dongles are also referred to as USB modem, because these are used in USB port. That is why these are also known as USB modem. Web stick यूएसबी सिस्टम कनेक्टर्स और यूएसबी पोर्टेबल ब्रॉडबैंड स्टिक, दीज आर इट्स अनदर नेम्स। डोंगल्स आर मेन स्ट्रीम इन लाइट ऑफ फैक्ट दैट दे ऑफर मोर प्रोमिनेंट अडेप्टेबिलिटी दैट सेटल्ड लाइन एसोसिएशन एंड कुड बी यूटिलाइज ऑन द गो। डोंगल्स गिव एक्सेस टू द इंटरनेट यूटिलाइजिंग द सेम 3G 4G इनोवेशन एज सेलुलर टेलीफोन। इट मीन्स वॉट? Dongles are used in USB port, that is why they are also known as USB modem. They have another type of the names, that USB system connector or USB portable broadband sticks, and this uses 3G and 4G technology by establishment of the network. Is it okay? Now next thing we have to study is GPS. GPS, Global Positioning System. The full form of GPS is Global Global Positioning System. GPS is a space-based navigation system that provides location and time information in all weather condition anywhere on or near the earth where there is an unobstructed line of sight to four or more GPS satellites. It means what? Here GPS, Global Positioning System, is the system which provides the directions and the position of any object, moving object, whether a stationary object, and this help us to go anywhere or to find out the position of any object which is present on the earth surface, any destination, any building, any location, any area which is present on the earth surface. And it is this global positioning system is installed or made by using geostationary satellite which are about 30 in number, okay, and the areas which are in direct connection or direct observation by the satellites, and these all satellites communicate with each other, and thus any person which is connected with this satellite can take help for the navigation using GPS, and he can detect the position of another place or moving object. Now here, a GPS may get lost because the GPS signals cannot penetrate the very hard things like mountains, building, etc. They are in densely populated areas or the hilly areas where there are very high buildings or there are very high mountains. Sometimes these signals are lost. Radio waves. A GPS may get lost if it can't sense the radio waves. Radio waves travel in a straight line and they don't pass through metal or rock easily. So in a tunnel downtown surrounded by the tall buildings or even under heavy tree covers, a GPS can lose their its position. It means GPS position is lost when an object is hidden by the high building, by very thick plants, very thick tree cover. So because the radio signal by which these all navigation system work cannot penetrate these things. That is why in such condition GPS signals are lost. Is it okay? Now next thing is infrared transmission. Infrared. Infra means below, red means red light transmission. In this type of the transmission, infrared waves are used, which have slightly less frequency than that of the red light. And now let us discuss what has been written in your book. Infrared transmission refers to the energy in the region of the electromagnetic radiation spectrum at wavelengths longer than those of visible light but shorter than those of radio wave. It means the wavelength of infrared system is greater than visible light and less than radio waves. And here correspondingly infrared frequencies are higher than that of the microwaves but lower than those of visible light. Is it okay? Now it is clear that the infrared frequencies are higher than microwave and less than visible light. Infrared waves. These waves have a frequency ranging from 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz, right? Frequency of infrared waves ranges from 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. It has a frequency range that just less than that of red light. We have already discussed this. That is why name infrared had been given to it, and hence the name. These waves are used for short range communication, approximately 5 meters. That is why infrared systems are used in remote controls in general. In variety of wireless communication, monitoring and control application, it travels in a straight line. This is also very important that it travels in a straight line and cannot penetrate through solid objects and is therefore used in home entertainment remote control devices like TV, CD, DVD, plotters, cordless mouse and intrusion detectors. In these type of the devices, infrared technologies are used, right? But generally you see that in remote control it is generally used, and by this you will be familiar. So these are the technologies. Here you can see that there is a television and it is being controlled via remote control, and here infrared technology is being used, right? So these are the wireless technologies which are used for the setup of network and for the transmission of the data or information. So this is all about the chapter.